Welcome back to Let's Play Disco Elysium Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, and we're heading back to Cuno to tell him that we met his father and we're not giving him speed. What does it do again? Plus one Motorex, minus one morale. Motorex. Same as this. Plus one physique, minus one morale. Physique. Motorex. I wonder if that would help there. Hand-eye coordination. I did just save, right? Just in case. I don't know if this would work. Motorex. They got this speed and they got that speed. Electrochemistry says, now that you've acquired some stimulants, it's time for a little pick-me-up. Time to detect. Alright, okay, my body's ready. Let's do this. Boy. You raise the Preptide bottle, press one nostril close, and inhale furiously with the other. The rush is almost immediate. It tastes bitter and caustic, and stings a bit inside your nose. Mamma mia! Now that the taste is slowly receding into your throat, I got experience with that. The rush is growing in intensity, your little heart pounding like a bird in a cage. A sweat breaks out across your brow, your jaw clenches. That's a secret task? Okay. We leveled up. And let's be honest, there's a little chest pain, the good kind, of course. You might want to blast a Nausifed or something. Logic says, you could work with this high, like literally work. Solve the case, file some papers, maybe clean up your hostel room, then solve another case, then start a side investigation into the paranatural, then build a radio computer. Composure says, whoa, this crap is strong. It's disco. Feels great. Are there any downsides to this at all? Electrochemistry says, to this? You kidding? There are downsides to not being on it. It doesn't wear out while we're using all this, doing all these conversation things. Volition says, there are massive downsides. It's a potent neurotoxin. You're turning yourself into a frayed idiot. Okay, cool, let's boogie. Finish thought and spring to action. Spring, spring, electrochemistry says. Everything is clear around you. You're ready to concentrate on your next task in the task chain. In the bottom right corner of the skin is a speed button. Right. That. It goes plus one to motoric skills. Perception, reaction speed, hand-eye coordination we want for the bullet. Savoir faire, interfacing, and composure. This is good before a white check, but damages your morale. Alright, well, can we now do this? No. Oh! It means now I can level up hand-eye coordination. What about... what's the other one? Conceptualization I decided I wasn't going to do. Accept changes. Fractured bullet. There you go. One more time. I can't see putting it any higher than that. Very high. Come on. Finally. Hand-eye coordination says, a rifle. Revolutionary period. Your bullet looks to be an old 4.46mm from the surplus left over from the turn of the century. Probably an antique or a retrofitted antique. Make? The 4.46 caliber was widely used with the Bell McGrave rifle, a Revacholian manufacturer. The BM dominated the battlefields of the Insulindian theater of the Anti-Centennial Revolution 50 years ago. Incidentally, you have just such a rifle with you. The dusty old thing you found hidden in the basement below the commercial area. It's unusable, sadly. If it were, the bullet would probably fit the chamber. Is anyone still making these rifles? No, but Zilegger, a major firearm manufacturer, ended up with a surplus after the war, so there's still a lot of those old military rifles floating around. Usually broken, the quality was appalling. Who uses Bell McGrave rifles these days? Antiques, enthusiasts, guerrilla fighters in distant countries, a few lucky jamrock bangers. You're looking for the same thing you found in that hidden weapons cache, only in working order. The lieutenant jots something down in his notebook. What are you thinking? Bullet? I think I know where this came from. Okay, and? The shot probably came from a Bell McGrave rifle. An antique? That makes sense. There can't be many breech-loading rifles floating around in Martinez or anywhere in Revacholac, really. That's probably a good thing. He nods. I have to hand it to the monarchs. It's quite admirable that they took the advice of criminologists last century and banned the use of breech-loaders in peacetime. Some new RCM recruits get impatient with their muzzle loaders once they've trained with military-grade weapons, but they realize it's worth it in the end. Encyclopedia says, prohibiting peacetime law enforcement of front-loaded rifles is a policy enforced by the Moralist International in all the nations of the Real Belt. Worth it in the end. Makes you consider every shot. I like it. Imagine if everyone, cops, citizens, had access to firearms that could shoot multiple rounds without pausing to reload. After the first shot, the second, third, and so on, come much easier. But back to the investigation. Seems like we were looking for an antiques enthusiast. Doesn't seem that likely, but we'll check out all possible leads. Next step, finding the gun itself. Find a murder weapon. Okay, we checked off that. So we need to locate a working firearm that shoots 4.46 ammo. Got it. Let me take this wall again. This isn't the wall, is it? Wait a second. It's this. It's not gonna work, though. It's not Motorix. Right? Right. Alright. Hopefully not that important. Or important at all. But we're getting some frame rate hits right here. I do not know why. 23 frames a second, locked in. Hold on a second, guys. 22 frames a second? Oh, I didn't... I hit that? No. I was just aiming this way. 23... Hold on one moment. It's not really improving. I don't know what to do about it, though, so... It's just... So, the way things are scrolling past the buildings... And the terrain, it looks horrible. I'm not giving him speed. Sorry, Cuno.
Fuck, does Cuno care?
I took care of the drug situation. Alright, so you got Kuno's kilo. He rubs his hands together. Here's how we do it. First, you give Cuno Kuno's kilo. Then Cuno gives you half back. That's how we split it. It's the best way. Street way. Aren't you gonna ask how I got past your dad? Word on the street is he sent your little friend in dressed as a hooker. What? Distraction style. That's some sick stuff. He nods approvingly to Kim. Not a single muscle moves on Kim's face. Cuno wants to hear all about it, but first we split the kino. Kilo, he leans in. Then we shoot the crap. I'm keeping it. You don't need more drugs. You're 12. All right, he taps the side of his head. Cuno knew you'd try that sneaky pig crap on him. Tell him, Cuno. Cuno's got brains. This crap don't surprise Cuno. He squints at you. So Cuno's gonna give you one more chance. Know this, pig. Crap is major. Major choice, pig. Cuno won't take that crap lightly. The pieces are moving, pig. This is domino crap. Logic says, it's hard to see how not giving a bag of amphetamine would cause some catastrophic cascade response. It's hard to see how not giving them... Inland Empire says, hard to see, but easy to feel. Somehow this will change things. Tick, tick, tick. The boy flicks an imaginary domino piece with his index finger. Decision time. What's it going to be? You gotta screw the Cuno? This is staying with me. What's gonna happen? Alright. He throws his hands up in the air. You screwed the Cuno. Everybody, Cuno got screwed by his pocket pig. Just when we getting our business on, the pig throws it all away. Cuno S says, I told you we can't be trusted. I told you. The little rat repeats it 6 or 7 times. I told you he'd steal the stuff. Relax, see? We got plenty of kilo. Kilo underground, in the tree. This ain't about that. He turns to you. This is about you and Cuno. You mismanaged this stuff. Now everything is screwed between us. How are you going to make this up to the Cuno, huh? Drama says, there is genuine disappointment below the axe, sire. I looked around in there. It's not the easy life you've got going on in that apartment. Hell, you know about Kuno's life. Kuno's got plans. Get the hell out of here. Yeah, we got plans. Cuno, I met your dad. Yeah? How the hell are you still alive, pig? Ha ha ha, Kim dressed as a hooker. I killed your dad, okay. Cuno, your dad is a half-dead alcoholic. He was sleeping under some clothes. What? His eyes become large and round. Composure says his posture changes. The swaying rooster motion stops for a second. Then he gets it going again, reorienting himself. Hell right, Kuno's dad was sleeping like a bum, he snaps back. Cuno told you, Kuno's dad doesn't give a crap about anything. Breaking and entering stuff? That's nothing to Kuno's dad. You got lucky, pig. Cuno knew this. He points to himself. Kuno's violent fiend, Dad's been drinking hard lately. Cuno knew you'd have a way in. Narrow window. Cuno window. Rhetoric says, Cuno window? Cuno window? Come on, kid, just stop. How are you trying to do? Get the Cuno to stop? Cuno's just getting it on. His tone wavers. Keep your crap together, Cuno. Stop acting tough, kid. You don't have to be scared of him anymore. Cuno's not trying to be rough, he pushes on bravely. This stuff is real. Cuno's violent dad's gonna be a vegetable. Cuno knows that stuff. Stroke, crap, stomach fuck... excuse me, sorry, guys, I messed up. Stomach screwed up and... Cuno's gonna go out like that, too. Cuno's gonna be just like Cuno's violent dad. Speed, crime, screwing on the bed, go out West Revachol style. Cuno West says, stop saying all this sad stuff, Cuno. The whisper comes smaller than usual. Hell, you talking sad? The kid breathes in and out like a boxer. Kuno's got hard crap, he punches the air. Death crap, nothing crap. You don't have to turn into that. He pushes the air again. He punches the air again. Get your nun ass out of here before Cuno screws it dead. Another punch. Faggot, you think because you took Cuno's speed, Cuno's going to sob like a fag? Turn into... He pants from exhaustion. Cuno ain't turned into crap. Cuno is that crap. Cuno won. You won, Cuno. The relief is palpable. The little hat jumps up and down behind the fence. Volition says he did not win. There is a crack in there now, and it's spreading across the face of his certainty. There were tons of unpaid utility bills there. Hell right there were. 3 years of some crap. Redrick says, you can guess. That's no place to live in. You have to find somewhere else. That's right. It's a bleep hole. Cuno's gonna move underground. Le Rayom, ancient crap. Cuno's gonna live in a catacomb. Yeah, in a tomb, Cuno. The little one seems overjoyed at the prospect. In a tomb. I did right not to give you the drugs. Let's conclude this. That didn't change anything, pig. That only made things work. Social worker crap. It doesn't work, pig. It doesn't work, Cuno. Only our stuff works. Redrick says she must repeat it. Use every chance to confirm that version of reality. What happens next? Dominoes falling, or is he just... Is that just bravado? Speaking... In any case, yeah, that's done. Find speed and sniff it. Great. Well, it helped me analyze that bullet. That's the only thing I can say. Hopefully I don't have to take it anymore. Although my morale is getting a little low. That's taking more drugs by doing that, isn't it? Yeah. I use Nausifed or Magnesium or something like that. We need to get back across the way. We'll help the Raver kids. Can I ask him again about the gun? Wait a second. Oh, you know what? This old lady. Right, I kept thinking about that. How do I... Where is she again? I'm thinking it might be her. On the other side of this monument somewhere she is. Well, maybe she's not there now. Well, here she is. So her name was Pig. Pale Driver. I don't know. I don't know. I don't have a choice to ask her about the gun or anything, so. And then maybe we'll get something else out of... Like, she'll just find their own way. what do you call it? The pawn shop guy. Hello again.
Hello again. How can I help you?
Electrochemistry. Have people from Everett Claire's Union come here to track that gun? Maybe. Shady-looking guys came in here yesterday, looking like they'd just taken off their Wild Pines overalls. They asked if I have a police weapon to sell. I told them I already sold it. They went their way. It was a trip. But you know, all sorts of people come here, asking for all sorts of things. Reaction Speed says, wait, then it might be true, Everett claims. Kim says, maybe Claire really is tracking down your gun. The lieutenant's eyebrows rise slightly. Tracking down? Looks like you already found the person who had it, though. Drama says, people are as oleaginous as Everett. I don't know that word. Seem like they're lying, even when they're really being truthful. Oleaginous, like slippery? Untrustworthy? Don't like that. Alright. There's nothing else to say to him. I don't feel like putting into electrochemistry just to figure out if he's ever sleeps or not. Seems like a waste. I mean, you never know, but... A faint smell of soldering, melted insulation, nylon, and ozone. That's interesting. This isn't open yet, right? It doesn't seem like a place we could go at some point. No, alright. Back to talk to... who again? Oh yeah, these people. On the ice. Past the village. No, I don't want to talk to her. Not the people on the ice, the Soona in the church. Just past that. Wait. A kick drum pulse. The music is coming from somewhere on the ice. The same address the lead program of Fortress Accident was looking for. Is there something new going on over here? Should I investigate that first? I mean, we know this already. Hello?
Hello again.
I mean, I know about the pulse. Is it just something from before? That I didn't see? A pile of nasal sprays. Brand name Nasofed Ultra.
Hi again. So, how are things going? Incremental progress! Yeah!
I see you're here again, offside man. Did I mention getting...
Yeah, we're going. I guess that was a little cue that we should have seen earlier before we met the people here. The rave kid type people. Alright, let's go talk to Soona. The sooner we talk to Soona, the better. Reaction Speed says, hey! Her innocence, Dolores Day, like little figurines, right? Like holding little men between her fingers, remember? What? You have the headless fallen rider figurine. You should give it to her. Win her back. What? Win who back? I can't win her back. She's a long dead historical figure. Don't be so pessimistic. Love doesn't die that easily. Inland Empire says, this isn't funny. You have a bad feeling about this one. I do have a bad feeling about this one. But I should, yes. This is a task of mine now. Offer figurines to Dolores Day. I have to see. Reaction Speed says, so very, very, very nifty. Nifty and mysterious. This is surely what the figurines are for. Dolores Day was fond of figurines. She deserves more. You should offer her any and all you have one day, if you meet her in person. What an odd task to give yourself, but here we are. You can't meet her in person. She died long ago, right?
Yes, what is it?
About the off-site copy you asked me to bring. Yes? I brought you the filament. Thanks. She takes the filament, inspecting the metallic tape on its side. Looks like it's the one. What's going to happen now? Now I'm going to print it out to see what's left of it. She's already inserted the filament into the radio computer's core, ready to close the door. Don't waste your time. Probably a bad idea to tell her we already looked at it, right? Okay, what are you even hoping to find? I have a theory, she says, as the filament clicks into place. Lintel was able to divine the location of the anomaly from this broken copy. I want to repeat their calculation, only this time with better equipment. Watch, she says, and presses print on the machine's keyboard. What an intricate display of failure. The paper starts filling out with ink, soaking it in a gleaming blackness. Not a single line of data stands out. Interfacing says, this is wrong. Machines shouldn't behave like that. Something's very wrong with that filament memory. Soona doesn't reply, her hands running over the printout. She's looking for something for her morning star, eyes scouring the millimeters. So she's not surprised. Here, she suddenly says, rising her ink-stained fingertip. I found it. Where? Lean closer. Hold on. She's behind the keyboard now, typing in some numbers that only she understands. The terminal beeps, and the light inside starts pulsing like a glowing heart. Can I do anything? Shh! Just give me a second. I'm almost... She clocks up her typing speed. The lieutenant leans closer to whisper, I've never witnessed a programmer work before. Done! Soona jumps up from the keyboard like a spring. I've got it. I've found the location of the anomaly. There's a joy in her voice as she bumps her fist into air. You did it? You found the coordinates? I found the coordinates! She lets out a celebratory laugh. Interfacing says, great job! Oh my god, congratulations! Thank you! She yells back with a grin. So, where is it? Where is your 2-millimeter hole in the world? There! She points at the other end of the church where a group of water bowls forms a ritualistic arch in the swallow. Think you could help me again? She tilts her head, eyes sparkling. Sure. I need you to go move those water bowls for me. I need to double-check my calculations. Interfacing says, you like moving things around. Moving things around is calming. Just walk over to the circle and follow my instructions. Move the third bowl 2 centimeters to the left, and the fourth bowl 5 centimeters to the right. This should do the trick. Should I be writing this down just in case? Third bowl. 2 centimeters to right, just in case it's in a dialogue and it doesn't indicate. Fourth bowl. They're both to the right. Third bowl, 2 centimeters. Oh, no. Why did I say... Must have been looking on the wrong line. 2 centimeters to the left for the third pole, fourth pole, 5 centimeters to the right. Sure, no problem. Thanks, she smiles. Move the water bowls to the right position and report back. All right. Wait. Which one's the fourth bowl and which one's the third bowl? From her? 1, 2, 3, maybe? I'm not sure. It's awfully silent again, as if someone turned off the entire world outside those walls. Water inside the bowl stands still. Perception, sight, says measurements have been marked down around the bowls, each chalk line representing a centimeter on the floor. Interfacing says, oh boy, this is going to be good. Okay, this is... Okay, third bowl. Right, that's correct. Move the third bowl from the left 2 centimeters away. It moves like a ghost without creating a single trace of sound. Of course, this is a dead zone for sound. Move the fourth bowl from the left 5 centimeters to the right. Some water spills out of the bowl, wetting the floor. Is that bad? The lead programmer sends you an encouraging thumbs up from across the hall. Physical instrument says, time to run back, or maybe walk. This is a sacred place, after all. Let's walk. Sacred place.
Yes, what is it?
I moved the water bowls to the right position, just like you asked. What's next? Great, everything should be aligned now. She stops, biting into her chapped lip. What's wrong? Yeah. She snaps out of the lull. Nothing. Now the only thing left to do is unmute the headphones. If you got the location right, we should be able to hear whatever sound this anomaly makes. Isn't it going to be just silence and nothing else? I don't know. She stares at the heart of her computer. That's what I'm scared of. I don't know. It could be anything. I mean, what sound does the nothing make? How can you even listen to something that doesn't exist? She turns to face you, the mainframe throwing shadows on her chin. What if silence is only what surrounds it, but the swallow itself is... She grows silent, her face very pale in the cold light of electricity. What? I don't know. I'm just scared. Maybe it's going to be something terrifying. Maybe it's going to tear the world apart. Conceptualization says, like that evil ink that filled the printout, erasing coherence and meaning. You're right. We should be cautious. We don't know what we're dealing with here. Maybe. She rubs her face. Maybe I'm just tired. It's scary, but we just have to face it. Yeah. She breathes in. You're right. Let's do it. She puts on her oversized headphones, ready to press unmute on the keyboard. The lieutenant takes a step back. And then nothing. Nothing happens as Soona Lukanen Killed presses unmute on her keyboard. Nothing but silence. Perception hearing says you can hear some small animal cross the floor in the chancel. It's that quiet in the sanctuary. Can you hear anything? She doesn't answer, her eyes closed and brows knitted together in a state of deep focus, one hand cupping the headphone. Well? Damn it. She lets out a loud sigh before tearing off her headphones. She's still avoiding your gaze. Well, at least the world seems to be still all right. Yeah, yeah, she says, disappointed. Nothing happened. Let's move on. Despite her fear, Empathy says, she was hoping for something extraordinary to take place. What do you mean nothing happened? Did you find the swallow? No. She rests her face on her hands, massaging her forehead. No, my hypothesis was wrong. According to this, I should have heard something, if I got the coordinates right. Like I said, silence is only what surrounds it. But this... She raises her head, staring at all the machines that litter the church, cables coiling up on the floor like pests. This is just another failure. Silence sounds like silence. That's all it is. You could try on the headphones, see if you can hear anything, but don't get your hopes up. Inland Empire says, silence is silence. You're sure there's more to it? This can't be it. You should have a listen. Legendary. Putting on the headphones. Plus one for helping Egghead with his jam. Plus one for found a melody for Egghead. Success. Everything disappears. You are draped in silence like a drowning man staring into his puny little headspace. And the pressure changes. What does it mean? It feels like flying on an aerostatic, or when your ears pop, or like a subtle difference in the atmosphere, a weather change hanging in the air. What if the sound you're looking for is too low for you to hear it? Soona, what if we just need a better sound system? A better sound system? She repeats. All right, but where would we get one? Perception hearing says suddenly a rhythmic beat permeates the walls, causing a small patch of decorative stucco to crumble onto the wooden floor. The Rave Kids? They should really allocate some renovation funds to this place, murmurs the lieutenant, inspecting the damage done to the arabesques. No, what they really should do is shut down the disco men for disturbing neighborhood peace. Yes, but they could help with the speakers. You mean the speed freaks? She closes her eyes as more dance music invades the holy silence of the sanctuary. Of course, the speed freaks. They have a fantastic sound system. And you think they would help me? They would if you wouldn't mind them moving in with you. I guess I could live through a week or two of peaceful coexistence. Great. I'll go talk to them. Sure. Let me know how it goes. She lingers for a moment before adding, thanks, officer. Okay. Before I mess with this, we're gonna go talk to them. Report back to Andre that they can move in. That's gonna be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. Always. Seek adventure.